the Elgato Game Capture, and fire up some UMass Dynasty. Blast from the Past Retro right here. NCAA 13, yes sir. Take a look at our schedule so far. I had to remind myself how we were doing in year six here. We just had the bye week. The last time we streamed this, I'd have to look back to, well, I have it pulled up here, to look back to when we played it last. It was March 21st. I live streamed this. March 21st of last year. That was episode 76. So it's been almost a year. Huh. Okay, I didn't think it was that long ago, but apparently yes. So, why did I not have this as part of my UMass playlist? I should probably look this up right now. It was on that playlist. Okay. Why didn't you tell me that? Anyway, that's just a little housekeeping. How is everybody doing? I was thinking of what I could stream tonight, and I'm like, yeah, you know, I've been meaning to do this since I've started hitting the live streams the last couple weeks. This is one of the ones I had in mind doing was UMass, so wanted to get back in on this. So we're number seven. We have lost two games, so we're probably out of the national title picture. Well, I shouldn't say that. I think when we were in the national title game, we played Michigan State, and they had three losses or two losses, something like that. So I guess we still have a chance. But we're number seven, and Georgia's number six at 4-1. So, I mean, yeah, we definitely stacked our schedule here. As you see, we lost to, well, now number one, Michigan. And we lost to Notre Dame. But we've beat South Carolina. We beat Auburn. We beat Clemson. We beat USC. So we're 4-2. 2-1 in conference. Now, this is NCAA 13 we're playing. How much is this video going to take? I'm assuming you're asking how long is it going to be? With the game and recruiting, this is probably going to be about an hour to an hour and a half, I would guess. Depending on how long I take on the recruiting and all that stuff. So, that's the schedule. I just wanted to kind of refresh people where we're at, because I certainly needed the refresher. We should also maybe look at the depth chart, because I can't for the life of me. Okay, I still do have Joel Meadows. He's a junior, 92 overall. We had Wes Collins. It's the backup. He played when Meadows was hurt at times, I believe. We still have the speedster, Robert Vincent. How is he only 84 overall, really? 95 speed, though. Robert Vincent, when he gets out in the open, is like, boom, see ya. Fullback, I'm not worried about. Wide receivers, we lost one of the Ronnies. We have Ronnie Houston. But was it Ronnie? Why am I forgetting his name? Ronnie Parker? Something like that. We lost. He's gone. And Corey Harvey still. Okay, some of the names are coming back to me here a little bit. Tight end Blake Wesley and Aaron Jones. And oh, we got three at 80 overall. How about that? Cody Reed's an All-American, and yet we got him a third. What? What? Whatever. Okay. And then, as far as my D. Wait. Why do I have two Walter Scotts? Or why is he on there twice? It's the same player. It's funny it even lets that happen. Ben Birch, All-American, sophomore. Middle linebacker. All right. That's pretty much what I need to know. We do not want autosave. Cancel. No autosave. Yeah, I want manual save in case something goes wrong. I forget where you do that. It's somewhere in here. Hang on, guys. We'll get to starting up this game in just a second. System. Auto save off. Okay, just check. How long have I had this YouTube channel? Where is it that it shows that? I know I just saw it. Oh yeah, I gotta leave that page. Leave this page. Where is it that it says that? I know I just saw it. On... It's either 4 years or 5 years. But I forget where it says it. I thought it was on the main channel page. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time on this, but I swear I just saw it somewhere. Oh, probably the about page. April 25th, 2011. 5 years in April. Okay, not to know that and get that out of the way. Let's get up. This could be a good one against. All right. Oh, it's always crazy coming back in here. I can't remember if I used alternate playbook or what I used to use here. It'll come back to me eventually here. I really wish I could have the uniform choices that they had in NCAA 14 for UMass, but I never did finish the project of porting the thing over. I just don't think it would have worked well. Plus, I hated the I hate the recruiting in 14. I really do. Let's go black pants today. All right. Oh, that's right. I use Oklahoma offense. Okay. Whatever, let's do it. This is a home game, which hopefully will help us. It's too bad this isn't the version of the Georgia Bulldogs that would have Sam Slinger on it. That'd be a heck of a matchup. Although we played against Cam Slinger in the championship game against Michigan State. If you guys haven't watched the UMass Dynasty, oh, there's lots of gems to go back and check that out if you find the playlist there. Wicked Bananas is back.
For this top 10 yeah. Battle has been building. Time for us to give you a live.
This obviously was a long-standing series. I'm counting the live streams.
Everybody, not only.
Oh, okay, bud. I'm doing a live stream.
Get those nerves in order.
How are you doing?
Time for ESPN's College Good. Football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit will be on the call. Brad, take it away.
Sweet.
UMass Stadium in Amherst, the university founded in 1863, and now home to 27,000.
He got Super Mario Maker the other day for his birthday.
Bring you this exciting college football.
Use some gift cards.
Hi everybody, I'm Brad Nessler, joined in the booth by.
How was the dentist? The dentist was not eventful, which is always good.
Presentation of college football is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. And we've got a good one that features the Georgia Bulldogs and the Minutemen.
All right. Boy. Clearly, I haven't played NCAA 13 in a while because when did I say I streamed this last? March? So hopefully I figured it out. No, this is NCAA 13, not 14.
We're a good way through this incredible season, and we've got what looks to be an exciting game.
Unfortunately, if they had game saves that would port from game to game, we could have done that. You know, if they had it like MLB is, but nope.
On the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Coleman's birthday was January 9th. They're going to defer and kick the football. All right. Here we go.
Lined up to kick this
get this thing underway. Number 6 versus number 7. That kick is not going to be returned.
Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
Are we hearing game sound? I want to just check on this. Oh, yeah. Whoa. Hit the wrong button there.
Good stuff, Reese. Thank you.
Went for volume, and I backed off the page. Yeah, and Red Lobster ads playing. Thank you. I just wanted to know if I had game sound. That's all.
UMass, Give us a sense of how they're off.
Yeah, so I'm, you know, I think the disadvantage let's see how well we do with this. I know the challenges of, I know all the animations and stuff are completely different in this than 14. 14 started using the get back there and make good decisions. What do they call their system of
if you don't have both of those things, it's going to be
gameplay and all that stuff, where the like, not the ragdoll physics, that's you know, the where they kind of fall all over each other. It was implemented in Madden first, and it finally made its way into NCAA in 14. I can't remember what their term for it is. I forget. Okay, they got one of their studs out here. They better get the block. So, okay, I'll go in. Yeah, okay, yeah. There we go. Shoot. If you could have really gotten outside. Everybody knows Vincent's got speed. Wait, Vincent? Is that his name?
From their own 42-yard line, it's first down.
Show us you can stop the run first before we pass. Bounce that. Here we go, Vincent. Oh, he got lit up.
Vincent
lit up, I tell you. I don't know if they will make an NCAA game anymore. Junk's hay-tailing again. I'm streaming my UMass Dynasty now. Let's go.
It's second and six.
Across the middle of the field here. I have a habit of waiting for the play art to go away on the field before I run a play. And that's mainly because I don't, it's my pet peeve of mine when I...
They got 5 yards on the play, and that's all.
Oh, maybe I'll have to do my Raiders game next. I have a pet peeve when I'm editing this stuff that I don't like to have to... I like to cut it and keep it clean without the play art on there so people don't know exactly, like, what play is coming up. It's just kind of my thing, so...
From the 49-yard line, it's third down.
I don't necessarily like it to show that I'm running a, you know, a hand on the paddle if I don't have to show it. So just kind of wait for that to go off the field. So I always think in my head of terms of editing a video, but it's a whole different ballgame when you're live streaming, obviously.
They don't turn it around. They're going to get.
You go to UMass? Oh, sweet.
The Badgers on top by four. In other games, let's get you up.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet because back in the day, we'd always get like Rob Blanchflower to, he'd like retweet the tweets about the videos and stuff. It's pretty sweet.
And for UMass, well, that's big news because
I want to bounce out this game and win. What was my, oh yeah, it was a stretch play every time.
It's first and 10.
Although,
ball on the 48.
This play was always quite successful unless you let their stud get inside there and blow it up, which they totally just did. An active NCAA 14 Road to Glory series? Yeah, I maybe. Guess I hadn't really thought about it. NCAA 13 was the one where you could throw deep, and you had like the corner glitch and stuff where they'd often let you go deep in like end of game situations. It's all coming back to me now. That was one thing that I liked about. Oh, where'd he come from? Holy smokes! Oh, that's right. Isn't NCAA 13 the year of the super linebacker too? I'm guessing yes by that play. Oh, that changes everything. I've got to remember that you can't smart... I don't know. It's harder to lead people to zones and things like that.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Beast Flower, yes. Hashtag Beast Flower.
Thomas up the gut.
And he's my defense. The guys are pretty well rated overall, but they just don't seem to play. If I can remember correctly, I don't think they played as well as a unit together this year. Hard to live up to that championship team, I guess. Although that's a nice play. That's Benny Burch right there. Yeah, he's got hops. See, I'm telling you, this was the year of the super. This was super frustrating because you always had the super linebackers.
Third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
They wouldn't even be looking at the play, and they make picks.
One of the top stadiums in the nation. This crowd.
I want
to play themselves. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
Hopefully that's a false start. Thank you.
They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of...
You live in West Georgia and go to UMass. Well, there you go, then.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. Townsend drops back to pass.
Make a tackle. There we go. Fourth down.
And they pick up 2 yards.
When am I uploading Joe Broadway next? I don't know exactly, but probably pretty soon.
Speed to turn that into something big.
Is this game worth it? Well, I'd almost be inclined to say any of the NCAA games are worth it, especially if there isn't going to be another one. But the dilemma for me is if you want to play Dynasty like this, there's trade-offs. The gameplay is much better in 14, much improved. The pass game is much improved. I think everything about the gameplay itself is better. But the recruiting, the system absolutely sucks. They tried to make an overhaul to it. And to me, it's just like pushing spreadsheets around. I don't feel like there's any personality to any of the recruits you're going after. You don't have any of the pitches like you do in this. I hated recruiting in 14. It just completely makes me not want to. That's probably why I don't play the Duke Dynasty more than I do, and it's definitely why I dropped doing Iowa State so early the year before.
And so far,
I just really hate the recruiting system. I've tried to start with a coach bumped up so he has privileges, but it's still not any fun. So I wish I could mix and match. Oh, geez. Okay, yeah. I'm remembering these guys now. I can't. I'm not going to be able to make Madden-style throws here. Not at all. Super defenses. Well, especially when I'm playing number 6 in the country. I got to be careful here.
From the 30-yard line. First down.
Nice play getting in the backfield. There we go. Yeah, I shouldn't have thrown that ball where I did. I should have just taken the underneath thing, but I'm like, maybe I can force it in there. That was a bad decision.
It's second down now and 14 to go. Ball on the 34-yard line.
I've got to remember in this game, they've basically got to be wide open or you could be screwed.
Tackle made at the 18-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with.
Am I undefeated? No, we're 4-2.
It's just a better call by the offense.
We lost to Michigan and to Notre Dame, which I wouldn't have known had I not gone back and refreshed my memory by looking at the schedule. I do remember we wanted to be very ambitious. We had just won the title. We didn't want to... Oh, he fumbled. Oh, they got it back. I'm like, why did he go up in the air? He got stuck. We get a replay?
From the 16-yard line, second down.
Get in there, make a play. Oh,
right around the 8-yard line.
First guy I tried to tackle got run over.
That makes it first and goal.
46 puts a shoulder down. Look out. Oh, they gave him first down. I thought he was just short. Well then.
And they've got their eyes on that goal line.
My gamer tag for everything is not as fan. For Xbox 360, Xbox One, PS4, PS3, it's all not as fan. The website I used to do jersey reviews got shut down. Yeah, it also got me community guideline strikes all across my channel. Pissed me off. I'm not doing any of that stuff anymore. Get him. Oh! Close to being a fumble.
Much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions.
How long has it been since I played this? Why, yeah, I looked when the last episode of this was, which was a live stream, and it was last March.
Or take off and run with it.
It's third and goal. Ball on the 11-yard line. And this crowd is going crazy.
This game has not made the list of backward compatible for PS4 yet, so you can't play it on there yet, or backwards compatible for any, or was it Xbox, I think I'm thinking of. Whoever it was that had the backwards compatible list, that's Xbox One, right?
Could take the lead with this field goal.
Anyway, it wasn't included. Not many sports games were.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is alignment.
UTSA is better than UMass. Here you go, Tasty Cake. It's always a Hurricane versus SGU thing. I know. I love people try to push out rivalry when we're good friends. Yeah, he had a good thing going with UTSA, though.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
I had an Iowa State dynasty. It was very short-lived. Mainly because of that NCAA the NCAA 14 recruiting deal. Okay, really? It's just not appropriate. We don't need this stuff over here. Okay. It's too bad you had to talk like that. Now you're blocked. Such immature.
This drive
whatever.
Will start.
All right. I just know this play is usually my money play in like Madden and any game, so I would hope this doesn't get picked. But either go inside quick or go to the tight end out.
That brings up second and five.
Go to what I should have run when I threw the second pick.
From their own.
Or what? Well, it is the play I ran, but let's try to hit the tight end instead. And they're blitzing. This should work. Oh man, they close quick. What do we got for a studio update? Now, speaking of Alabama, there they are. Down 3-0 to Kentucky right now.
We could be headed to a photo finish.
It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker.
End of the first quarter, 3-0 Georgia. You timed him out while I blocked him.
Got a 3-point lead.
All right. I've got to get, you know, one thing I love about Madden, especially this year, is I feel you can really exploit one-on-one. Like, you know, you have a running back against a tight end against a linebacker. You can really exploit that by throwing it somewhere near them, and they'll use their body to shield. You know, you go back to a game like this and you completely forget that they're not smart at all like that as receivers or quarterbacks.
On the run, first
down. Man, we got to fight just to get that first down. But he got it. You know, so I'll go trying to make throws, like, you know, when I'm playing like Sam Slinger and I got a tight end like Zach Ertz. I like, you know, he'll make some incredible plays. I just let him do his work one-on-one. I mean, he doesn't always make them. But, you know, there's always a good chance he's going
to
come up big. Okay. Is he going to wreck this play again? Nope, they got the block on him. But then, oh, get loose. Go. Not bad. What am I hoping the most will be in MLB 17 The Show? Well, I know everything's, you know, I'm pretty happy with how it is now. I'd really like for Play a Friend to be in Diamond Dynasty, so it actually would be like something I'd want to play. Because I love the concept of the thing. I want to be able to play it in live streams, show off some cool SGU uniforms I can make, you know, or that I have made. And just play with people in live streams. I don't want to play random people who are just going to try to cheese the whole time and stuff. So that's what I would like.
Comes away with a short gain on the play, and he also gets a first down.
He worked hard to get that first down. It won't go down as much in the box score, but he got the couple.
What does not as mean? Not as fan. It comes from my then brother-in-law was in a band called the Nottas. Yeah, it has to do with that. It's first down. That's a short story. Just use that for a lot of online stuff, and it kind of stuck. That was my original channel.
Vincent picks up about 4 yards on the play. That'll make it second to seven.
Which now NFL players are on the current or on the original game roster? Oh, I don't know. I'd have to go look.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the.
I'd have to load up an exhibition game with whatever. Rosters we had. Okay, I should be able to make this pass. No! I thought that was a ref. It just. Yeah. Linebackers are not fun to deal with in this game, especially with a good team.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five.
Where did SGU come from? Sports Gaming Universe. It's pretty self-explanatory, I think. At the time, Oh, that sack. Came flat in from the left side. Couldn't get the ball off.
You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket.
And I'm dealing with a pretty good defense here. Anyway, at the time, my Nottas Fan channel had some copyright issues from some stuff that I was doing before I did all the sports gaming, before Machinima, like when I really, you know, back then I really couldn't have cared what happened to my YouTube channel. I was just posting random like concert clips and I was doing Vikings like edited highlight things back like in 2009 when Favre was here, when we made the run to the NFC Championship. I was making fun highlight things and I was posting them on YouTube, but it was mainly, oh wait, why am I going for this? I don't want to go for this.
First time out of the half.
Talking too much. Wasted a timeout. So I was posting them on like a Vikings fan board or something for people to watch. It was just hobby stuff, but it was a lot of fun. And so then, you know, I started doing the, you know, the stuff I do now, the gaming stuff, and some old videos got flagged and got copyright strikes or whatever, and it basically was to the point where my channel couldn't be monetized because it was like claims from like NBC or something like that. They were never gonna, you know, let up on them. And so at the time, I'm like, well, I talked to Machinima and I'm like, well, I guess my only choice to be proactive here is to make another channel if they'd let me do that. And so that's when I went to something that would be more descriptive of, you know, what I'm trying to do. from then on out, which is all the sports gaming. So that's where I decided on Sports Gaming Universe as a channel, trying to be more descriptive of what was actually going on, because anybody who, you know, was just searching around and saw Nottas Fan, they wouldn't know what that is.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback?
Okay, that really sucked right there. This guy's a beast. Wait, what did I just pick?
First and 10, ball on the 33. Drops back to pass.
Get him.
Slides down to the play. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
The KY Cats ready to go in Lexington, and we've been keeping an eye on this one all day. We've got a tight one going on here. And for good,
why does the kicker have dreads? Because he's a black punter and he has dreads.
You can never look ahead a week.
Seriously though, the amount, like the number of black punters in this game is like really, it's like, wow, it's alarming. I think they're when you go through seasons where people are generated, there are a lot.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down.
Come on.
And they make the stop at about the 45. That's
good for this guy's wearing us down.
First down.
Well, I don't know. They've only thrown like one from their own decent pass on me, I think.
First down.
Should probably load this up.
Georgia is up a field goal.
Take away the run. Oh, of course, then they pass.
Fires quickly to the full. He's pushed out.
They knew what I was doing.
41-yard line.
Great touch by the quarterback. Floating that one right into his hands. That takes some skill.
It's my most favorite college football team. Well, it'd have to be the Gophers, Minnesota, but then Michigan's right there too for me.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 41. Runs it right. Nice pickup.
Gain of 4 on the play.
Keeping my defense on the field way too much here.
It's second and 7. Ball on the 37.
Do I play Madden 16? Yeah.
Gets to about,
I have a Vikings franchise going on. I've got a quarterback career mode.
Here's the 8th play of the series. He's going to come up short. Good.
Stop him. I almost feel like I should take a timeout here to save time, but.
Fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal.
See, it looks like Georgia's got a black kicker, too. And he missed.
And our score, 3-0, Georgia.
Would I rather the Vikings win the Super Bowl or Twins win the World Series? Vikings, by far. I've seen two Twins World Series championships in my lifetime. I'd definitely like to see Vikings Super Bowl.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two.
Yeah, I've played 2K5.
Like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
They're bringing a blitz, aren't they?
Tight end. They'll bring him down at the 39.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands.
Why are you telling me how to stiff arm? Okay. I think it's the first time. That's really bizarre. Whoa! Come on.
That's a loss of 2 yards.
Not good.
That'll make it 35.
I thought that would surprise him, but no. No, no, no.
3rd and 5 coming up. Ball on the 37.
Okay, now I should beat the blitz. Go.
He's taken.
Still not getting much. Jeez, that linebacker.
49-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 6.
Calling, hurry up. Let me call it here. I'm afraid to do play action. These guys are too fast. Okay. Okay, let's snap the ball. Hello?
He's gonna.
Come on, deep. Get there, get there. There we go, baby.
Again.
Vikings Super Bowl or Gophers National Championship? Again, I'll go Vikings Super Bowl. The Gophers National Championship is something that's very hard to fathom. Throw a Big Ten championship. That's hard to fathom. Rose Bowl appearance. That's hard to fathom. Yeah, they used to wear it. You know, they used to win it all the time back in like leather helmet days and stuff. But I think they have like six or seven national championships. But it's like, yeah, different era of football. Icon, hey man.
Is lined up to kick this one off.
Tee this thing up. Sailing downfield. Hopefully take a lead to half.
And they can forget about returning this one. They'll take over at the 25.
They're more likely to pass unless they're just going to run this thing out.
Trying to get a head start there.
They jump again?
The middle laps, but it's going to cost them 5 yards.
So the penalty in 15.
First and 15. I always forget what the mechanics are, or D-line mechanics are. Yeah, okay. Why is it giving me prompts like that?
He really fought to get to the quarterback that time. He's certainly shown that he can get it done on a week-to-week
basis. It's like you think I don't know. Probably has to do with not having played the game in a long time. I think so I'm new to it or something. It's like, whoa! He did not just do that. Hit him.
He's finally tackled.
Shoot.
The Bulldogs don't like the looks of things. They're going to take their first time out.
Well, that was unexpected.
First and 10 following that big run. Pass.
Play this more often? Well, it's not going to be an edited series anymore. It's going to be live stream only. Has been the last couple times around that I've done it.
Quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense, and in this case, he did. Nice job.
So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points.
Going for the 51 yarder. Yeah, they weren't even close on the last one.
And they come away empty.
If they have a weakness, it's in their kicking game. Do we dare throw one up here? I say why not.
Start at the 34. He may have changed things up here.
What's he have to lose? His third pick of the half?
One towards the end zone here. Meadows on first.
Oh yeah, I remember now. Oh, but he fell. No. I know he's securing the catch, but you got to stay up, buddy. No. But yeah, that was the defender, the D-back glitch. You could almost always go deep in a situation where you needed it.
Minuteman lead, 7-3.
Shoot though. If he just stands there, catches that ball, turns around, he probably can still score. Man, it's okay. We'll take the lead to half. We're good. Two streams one day must be a good day. Yeah. Stream is lagging. Not for me so far, and I'm not showing a low bandwidth notice, so I don't know.
Just about set to start the second half. If you're an offensive guru, you hated the first two quarters. We'll see if the offenses can come.
We'll keep an eye on it, though. Not that I really can do a lot about it, but
this one's going to be down in the end zone.
Keep an eye on.
Let's toss it down to Aaron Andrews for an update from the sidelines.
Both sidelines seem to be contemplating their offensive issues as the half ended, Brad. I heard some players talking to one another about their frustrations, but the answer from both coaches was basically, hey, there's an entire half to play, and we're going to have to come out more prepared to make something happen.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not seeing the lag on my end.
They'll go to work at the 25-yard line.
What stream did I do before? I streamed some Joe Broadway today. It's up on the channel. That's how we got to treat this guy.
He gains a couple of yards.
Although I'm a little afraid if we sell out on the run here, they'll beat us. With
second
the pass.
8 yards to go.
Guess that's what we gotta do, especially if they're coming out in I formation and run looks like this. Ah, see? I loaded up for it and it still doesn't help.
Makes it out to about the 40.
Jeez. See a team having success like Chance Thomas is gashing us. He's already got 107 yards.
From their own 40-yard line. First down.
Blow it up in there. There you go.
At the 38. There's an injured player.
Oh, he's hurt. He's hurt. I wonder how bad. Have to watch that one and see if he comes back. Oh, he's being carted off. I don't think he's coming back. Leaving on the cart. Woo. Tough break for Georgia there. Wonder what their backup's like. Is he another bruiser or is he a speedster? Oh, looks like another. I don't know. We'll find out. Get the sack. There we go. Ben Burch in on the sack.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds.
Ben, I remember you, yeah. And I'm still glad you're watching.
Challenges him to start playing a little bit better.
Where did I get the name SGU? I gave it to myself. I just told the story a few minutes ago.
Defense hoping.
But basically, I needed to come up with a new channel name because my Not As Fan channel was...
The intensity of this place.
Not being able to monetize videos at the time. I needed to start new, bring my... subscribers over to the new channel, so I picked a name that was fitting of what I was doing, you know, at the time. Obviously now starting to do the sports gaming channel, so that's what just came to me. And then later on, my buddy Sean Burgo, who out of the kindness of his heart designs that logo I still use now and some of the character logos, and
he gets it away, and this is a really nice punt.
Really cool dude. I met him when I went out to Boston. He and his wife took me out to dinner, picked me up at the airport. Really, really solid dude.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad was so much.
But anyway.
Really makes it tough to.
Yeah.
They'll go to work at the 23-yard line.
I really want to get Vincent going, but they've been kind of shutting down the run lately. Yikes, you're trying to strip the football there. No gain.
That brings up second and nine.
Am I going to do more Duke Dynasty? Yeah, I will. I just can't stand the recruiting. And I have a feeling when that team gets to the offseason, boy, I don't even think we're going to be able to replace at the level we have, more or less get better. I mean, I just can't make any headway with that recruiting.
That could be a check with me right there. Now he's scrambling.
The
26.
I'm like, I don't know if I want to be running on that play or not. Just waiting for one of these dudes to light me up. Yeah, how do those notifications work with somebody streaming on YouTube? I guess I don't know because I don't follow anybody. To get them.
Thanks, Brad. His back is really bothering him after that play. Right now,
that sounds like a pretty cool deal.
And the trainers are trying to stretch him out. He will not
wide open, stay in bounds. There we go.
Extended period of time. Brad, let's send it back upstairs to you guys in the booth.
Hopefully he isn't out for too many games. Thanks for that update.
Love the streams. Hate when you miss them. Well, at least they, I mean, I know it's not the same, but at least they go up as videos afterwards. It's nice. Be able to recap. Is there another stretch play that's more... No, I guess that's the one I always use.
From their own 43-yard line.
Run it to this side where dude isn't. Although they're more loaded up over here. Okay, get your blocks, get your blocks. Yes, there we go. Vincent out in the open. That's what I'm looking for. I just got to run away from their stud on the right side there.
He got just a little bit of daylight, and that's all he needed to turn that one into.
Ooh,
a big
play. Those are some sweet plays. They put two guys on the ground out front there. Nice job. Choose a new school if you need better recruiting. Well, yeah, but for Duke, I mean, I just said straight out, I'm like, look, there's only one way I'm going to do this. I'm bringing my created coach in, and I'm maxing him out to the highest point I can to start him off. And that he's in, I mean, really helped.
UMass is up by four.
Would I rather the Red Sox win the World Series or the Twins? Well, at this point, the Red Sox...
Oh, nice run. Go, go, go. Get in there. Oh, he almost got the pylon. Good run, though.
Well, the Red Sox have won three in the last decade, roughly. Well, 2004, 7, 13. I think I'd much rather see a Twins one at this point in time. I think it's less likely from year to year, but you never know.
First down, and they've got their.
I probably should not overthink this. I probably should just run the ball.
Really stalled on their last two trips to the red zone.
Come on, come on, get set, get set. Yeah, no, my first thought was right. It sends you a notification to your device saying so and so is streaming or uploaded a video. Oh, nice. Well, that's really good, especially if it's got uploads too and everything. I like the sound of that.
Second down and
so you just have to choose a channel that you're notifying. You're getting notifications then, obviously.
He's changing things up.
There we go, baby.
He got it. Touchdown. They had a mismatch and
a little hot route adjustment gets us a touchdown.
Had that one all the way, and there wasn't much the defense could do.
Who do I have for Super Bowl 50? You got Broncos and Cardinals. That'd be a good game. I'm actually thinking, you know, if I got to pick today, I'm going Panthers and Patriots. But what I want to see most likely would probably be Panthers and Broncos. Or I'm fine with the Cardinals too. Oh, Vincent sprained an ankle? Oh, on that last run, right. He had the long run, and then he was stuffed at the goal line.
He makes the PAT.
All right, well, one quarter. We'll deal with it.
And a touchdown as a result.
This defense is not only struggling, but they're giving up big plays, and that can really start to affect...
Sub to them and turn on notifications.
Slow down an offense when you're giving up so many big plays.
I'm still not showing... Oh. Wow. Well, Jones' overall is not much behind him. And high re-injury risk. We're not putting him back in right now.
Looks like they're ready for the kick.
But, yeah, I don't know. I'm not showing low bandwidth like those times that I've got. That, and my stream, personally, I'm watching it right here, and I'm watching it in... Oh, I guess I'm only watching it in 480, but it's not lagging. It's probably best that I do watch it in 480 because then I don't kill the bandwidth anymore while I'm streaming.
They'll start this drive at the 25.
But at the higher resolutions, maybe it's struggling a little more. I don't know.
Little handoff. Nice
Nice run.
Did they ever actually put the notification up for how long the halfback was gone? I'm assuming he's out for the game because he left on the cart, but
they need about 3 yards.
I guess I missed it.
Here on second down.
Get in there, make a play. There you go.
Let's get an update.
Linebackers seem to be my strength.
Action going on in Columbia. And for South Carolina, they're struggling to take control of this game.
From their own 30-yard line, third down. This crowd can really be intimidating for an opposing team.
Well, I mean, obviously there's something if multiple people are having some issues, but, oh, well, he had all day to throw.
And he's taken down at the 44. Gain of
14 yards. I'm just not seeing it on my end yet. Started the day with MLB and end with NCAA. Who says it's going to end with this? Huh? Wink, wink. Junk thinks I should stream my Raiders game later. I don't know if that's going to happen or not. Got to get kids ready for school day tomorrow. But you never know. Why UMass? Well, at the time that we did this, Mr. Hurricane and I were talking about what we were going to do for NCAA Dynasties, and you had two new schools added to the game, or was it three new schools? Maybe it was three new schools. Yeah, three. What was the third one? I'm forgetting now. Anyway, there were three new schools added to the game when NCAA 13 came out. UMass, UTSA, and there was one other one. And we're like, hey, okay. Well, why don't we do similar things? I'll take one of the new schools, you take another, and we'll try to kind of build them up. And so that's what we did.
So we're looking at another third down here. It's getting louder down in the field.
I'm not sure when that stream would start, to be honest, because I'd have to. Ooh, we overshot there. Fourth down. There we go. Had him open. Junk Johnson likes that. Wait, is that his name? I think it's. I forgot my coach's name already. I think it's Junk Johnson. That's really bad. I can't remember.
White awaits the snap.
What is my coach's name?
Excellent punt.
I'd have to go back to the first episode and find out.
This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20.
No, I don't want to run option. I tend to mess up option.
They'll set up shop at the 20-yard
line. Go down my playlist here. That's 54. Got a long way to go still. Bounce it through here. Get out. Go, go, go. Yeah, he's clearly not as fast, but...
The offensive line got
good running back. Okay, this is back to episode 29.
So with one quarter remaining, UMass leads it 14-3.
Still not there yet. UMass Dynasty, the dawn of a new era. But episode one. I want to say his name's Junk Johnson.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one.
Boy, that first year, oh, we just got creamed like just about every time out. It was bad.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Manhandled, but we built him up. Yeah, Junk Johnson. There we go. Just had to go back to my
first and 10
creation video.
36-yard line.
This is on Xbox 360.
And down he goes to the 38-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
You know, logically now, I feel like it's a good time for a play-action pass. Second. Only problem is
on
play-action never seemed to work real well on this. Like, they never seem to fall for it. It doesn't get set up like the way you think it should. and therefore is a real gamble. There we go, Wesley.
At about the 49.
No, I don't think Odell is overrated. I mean, he is just, I mean, wouldn't you say he was pretty much model of consistency? I mean, how many straight weeks did he have 100-yard games and stuff? I mean, he was great. Okay, I got to say, about like midway second quarter, I didn't feel like this would be where I'd be in the fourth quarter. Whoa, okay, yeah, jeez. They knew that was coming. PA boot, yeah. I love that play when it works. Yeah.
From their own 47-yard line, it's second down.
See if my halfback or my fullback can catch. Oh, he got, whoa.
He's taken okay. down around the 45-yard line.
That'll work.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
Hashtag put in Johnny Gomes. Yes. Wide open. Thank you. Money. Whoa. Really wide open. Down to the 15. Junk Johnson's fired up. Yes. That's what he wants to see.
They held off the blitz just long enough for the quarterback to make the connection and pick up some good yards.
It's first and 10 after the big pass play.
They're going to pinch this off. I should. Nope. That's not what I wanted to do.
98 Weasel! 98 Weasel!
Looks like he might audible out of that
play. Other side. Other side. Whoa, I don't have time for this. Yeah. Okay, bounce, go. I should have gone way outside. I don't know if I would have got there or not, but whatever. Running down the clock. Things are pretty good here. Just got to be careful. Should be doing quick pass. What was the one I'd always do with Blanche Flower? Because I basically had, like, no talent to start this thing off, and I had to rely on really quick. It's not slants. It was. Oh, this is a different playbook. That's why.
From the 13-yard line.
I'm using Oklahoma's playbook now. I can't remember how long I've been using this one. Standing there. Yes, there we go. Slant for the touchdown. I don't throw slant routes that often. I probably should more.
That's another touchdown pass. His third.
The one thing this quarterback does in
Johnny Combs universe.
Taking what the defense gives him. He's always looking for the open target.
Okay. Corey Harvey.
And he tacks on the extra point.
He was really
play 72-yard drive.
A good player, kind of buried on the bench there when
people expect offenses to spread you out and
our big wide receivers last year.
I still believe that the ability to move the football
has not anymore.
And right now what we're seeing from this offense is balanced. They're running, they're passing the football.
Yeah, good question. When's the next Vikings franchise episode? I'm trying to think of the best time to post that. I'm thinking that video feels to me like that's a weekend video. I don't want that to get missed, you know, Super Bowl and all. So probably this weekend. I'm actually excited. I want to... Whoa, pick it! Oh! I'm actually excited for that, and... when honestly, obviously I can play at any time regardless of when I'm going to post it, but I just feel like that's a weekend video to me.
Harris up the gut.
Whoa.
He's to the 40.
Okay, this running back can go too.
At the 50.
They got a couple bruisers back there.
That's just being a phenomenal athlete. He took the handoff on the draw play and made some pretty impressive moves and got a ton of yards.
When was the last episode? Whoa. When was the last episode of this series? Last March, I live streamed this. I had to look back. Because what I do is I always go grab the tags from... There we go. Here's the pick. Go, baby. Pick six. Oh, don't get run down by the quarterback. Nah. There we go. Pick six.
Great job here.
I'm standing there waiting for that at the sideline. I don't even know who that is. Whoa. Did you see the receiver that led him there? I'm assuming that's maybe a tight end. Just like didn't even look for the ball. That was interesting. Because I'm pretty sure he's the one that brought the defender over. That's crazy. Joey Bosa is a dude, man. I'm a Michigan fan, not anywhere near an Ohio State fan, but that guy's good.
28-3.
Sweet. La La La, huh? Everybody go download La 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 chorus on Super Mario Maker on the Wii U, because Coleman said so.
He boots it deep downfield.
Oh, more A's on the third law. Okay. Good to know. Yeah, I'd like to stream WWE, but I don't really have a universe mode set up per se. You know, I have thought about streaming Rufus Duke because, I mean, let's face it, nobody really watches the series anyway. It gets like 1,000 views an episode. So, I mean, and... I wanted to do more NXT, like stick around with the title for a while, but at the same time I feel like as an edited series it just kind of feels stalled, like it could use some progress going to the main roster, so maybe live streaming some NXT stuff for a while. Whoa. Okay then, he may be going the distance. Can they close on him? Nope. Well.
That was simply sensational running.
He could have played that better.
What kinds of major things can happen?
He got some blocks. But in that, you know, I guess in that way, I mean, would anybody really miss it if I live streamed ahead on Rufus Duke and then just basically did an update, said, okay, here we are, here's where we are. If you want to see some matches you missed, go see them. You know, maybe he'd be a better thing to just live stream anyway. I don't know. I couldn't be any fewer views. Not that serious. You know, it's kind of funny because, I mean, Max Masher didn't get, like, a ton of views, but it got more views than Rufus Duke did. Has.
South Carolina on top, 38.
So, I don't know. You guys have thoughts on that?
Here it's 28-10.
When will I upload the Super Bowl? That's what I was just talking about. I think that feels like a weekend video. Like, I should do that this weekend. You'd miss it? Well, I'm not necessarily saying that Rufus Duke... I mean, it's not going away, but I'd live stream it more, and then... maybe the thing to do is live stream him, and then... even if I live stream the pay-per-views... go back and edit the pay-per-view videos and put them up as edited videos. Because really, the stuff behind between it seems to be the same. I mean, it's like, I don't know how many times I've taken on Finn Balor, but it's like the same thing over and over and over and over and over and over and over again. So...
trying to lock one long. He's got a man wide open.
That was too easy. Jeez.
Touchdown! He's ringing up the points with
definitely glitched out deep coverage.
He puts in is finally paying off. It's been,
they get burned way too many times.
Some pretty good throws leading to some remarkable touchdowns.
Yeah, but you know, but in the end, the view count for Rufus Duke doesn't necessarily dictate if I do it or not, because it's fun to play. It's fun for me to play, first and foremost. And it's the way I do it. I don't really talk over the matches because I feel like I just don't have a lot to say during the matches unless something really big happens. So, like, just kind of doing the introductions. This is kind of the way I do Universe 2. I feel like those are pretty easy for me to put together regardless of how many views they get. So it's not really... It's not like, oh, I spent 8 hours editing this for you people. Now the universe mode is a lot more editing, and it takes a lot more time to play. So I guess in that respect, that one's a little more okay. But, you know, I don't feel like that sense of, oh, I poured my heart into editing this and nobody watched, but I should just quit it. It really doesn't, you know. Either way, I'm like, eh, I like playing it. I'm going to post it. I don't care if people watch it or not. It's fun for me.
So if you're the offense here, what's your mindset right now?
Well, I think they're anxious to get back out on the field. Last time out, they drove right down the field, so they know they can move it.
I'm about to make UMass win. Yeah, you got to go back and watch the series. I mean, I know you probably have to dig a bit to find the playlist and everything, but, well, I could probably just put the playlist in the chat with the link. But, yeah, I won the national championship with them the year right before this. Year five was our title win. It was sweet how it played out, too, because we had Cam Slinger, who was the cousin of Sam, one of my characters, and we put him in the game year one. Ah, he's trying to break away again. We put him in the game year one, hoping that he'd be our big quarterback recruit, and we get him, and, you know, he'd lead us to a national championship. Well, that was initially what's in my head. He wanted nothing to do with us in recruiting, went to Michigan State, got redshirted, you know, whatever. We checked on him once in a while, just, hey, how's Cam Slinger doing? Okay, is he starting yet? No. Well, he finally plays his junior. I think he either started starting in his junior or senior year. It took him a long time because he was behind other good quarterbacks. But wouldn't you know, we play him once in a regular season game in year five, and then we play him again in the national championship game. The guy we tried to recruit, the guy we made specifically to be a recruit that we were going after, and we play him in the national championship game, and we beat him. That was fun. Tracker, my bud, what's up? Yeah, we're going retro tonight. So far, success here. Excuse me. Audio's gone? I don't know, let me hear.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
Still there for me.
Out of bounds.
Oh, he just does get the first down.
Not a huge play, but an effective play nonetheless. Be able to pick up a first down. And again, this offense right now just making good decisions.
Playing Georgia makes me want to be back in Road to Glory with Sam Slinger, though. That was one of my favorite series that I've ever done.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's good for a game. And it got a little rated R for one episode, too.
Georgia's going to take their first time out of the half.
Oh, man.
We've got a second and five.
Patty Peaches.
46-yard line.
At B Wildcat voicing Sam Slinger.
At about the 45.
Doing little update things. It was cool.
And so it's another third down upcoming here.
Back to pass. I think I'm just now remembering how to use her D-line. I'm like, is it the button thing like Madden does now? Is it the stick and put pressure on him? That's another thing I think that got better in 14 that I really liked, that I really enjoyed about the gameplay. The gameplay was so different than the off-the-field stuff in 14. Gameplay got better. Recruiting took a step back in my mind. But how you could really
get the line play going. You could really, you know, even if they were staying in front of you, you could use them to push them back into the quarterback or into the running back, and I really liked that. You know, it felt, you know, people always are like, oh, why do you use the D line? You know, oh, only noobs do that. But I'm like, well, you know what? I was an offensive and defensive lineman. I'm going to play what interests me, line play, you know, trying to beat a guy off the line. That's the stuff that interests me. I wasn't a D-back. I mean, and plus I suck at it. When I use her back there, I pretty much always ruin things. But I do what interests me, you know. Oh, he's going to... Oh, I got lucky there. He had pick six on his mind right there, and he almost got it. I shouldn't even be throwing right now. From their own, this is NCAA 13. It's first down. So after the game, we'll do our week of recruiting. And to be honest, I have no idea. I cannot remember for the life of me who... Oh, Vincent's back. He's probably going to get hurt again, though. Yeah, okay. I don't need the on-screen prompts. Thank you. It's very odd that they're showing up. We don't have to run another play, but we can go in a victory formation here, I suppose. Because why not? We'll do it for effect. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here. Big victory taking out number six. Favorite play in football. Here we go. Quarterback, take a knee. Didn't look like it was going to happen early on, but we turned it on.
Today we saw a game that wasn't even close. UMass 35, Georgia 10.
I just feel like, you know, I don't know. For whatever reason, there's like this mindset of how you play Madden or how you play 2K and whatever. Like, you know, and if it's like we always get into it about people with people saying change your camera in Madden or change your camera in 2K, you know, with my career. I'm like, no, I play the one I like. You know, I don't have to have it like everyone else. And they're just like, you know, if it's anything different, people just like get thrown for a loop and are like, oh, change it. So, I mean, it's the same thing with, like, oh, you use the D-line? What are you doing? But, yeah. My whole thing, like, throughout my whole YouTube thing, if anybody wants, you know, often people are like, you know, do you have any advice? Don't play what everybody else wants you to do. You know, you play the games you want to play. Play them the way you want to play them. Yes, it's great to get feedback, and feedback's very helpful. And, you know, I've changed in Corpulson. Don't do it just because everybody says to do it. Do it the way you want to do it. Because then you're going to play for a long time. You're going to have fun. I mean, to me, I don't think you can really be any good at doing this if you're not having fun with what you're playing. I'm terrible at most of these games, but I play them. And I like to, you know, do the commentaries and make stories out of these things. So, I mean, that's my focus. My focus isn't going out being the best Madden player there is, or, you know, I play too much variety to get good at any one of the games I play. Yeah. Whoa. My stream did something weird there. That's the first time I saw any look of that. It's kind of a blurred screen there for a second. But there we go. I get the 35-10 win. Let's go check recruiting. Advance the week. That's the other thing in 14. I mean, I know they're trying to save time, but it's such just like a spreadsheet thing. It's like, I got to the point where I didn't care one recruit over the other. I didn't feel like I had a rooting interest on who I got. I mean, obviously you want the higher overall guys, but then once the numbers were set, you pretty much don't do anything week to week. You just kind of let it stay. So anyway, I like this recruiting system. Like, could they do some things to make this better? Sure. But the direction they went in, I was excited when they overhauled it. I'm like, oh, cool. It'll be a new recruiting thing. And then I got into it. I'm like, oh, I hate it. So we have 21 scholarships remaining. McFarland and Bird are visiting.
Okay, so we got a 78 overall tackle, we got a halfback, we got a middle linebacker, and we've got a quarterback.
Alex Thornton coming in at a 79. Dang.
Okay. Well, I think I have this sorted to have most of the higher overalls at the top. Oh, we got a couple soft UMass recruits. Nice. We got a soft Ohio State. Hey, we'll still take a crack at him. Let's set these visits. Oh, it's already set. Looks good. Wait, why do I have no scouting time? Did I already start in on this?
Maybe I started on the last one. Maybe I set the visits up and stuff, because it feels like I've already done something here.
He wants to visit. All right, let's just start at the top of the list and go. I know he's a soft to Ohio State, but let's take our best chance here. Take me a second to remember how I do this. We swayed him to average. Okay. Not on that one, though. See what we can do to knock him back, but he's a soft commit. I doubt we'll get him. Let's see where we are with him. Oh, we got a pretty good lead. Take our points where we can get them, knock them back. Yeah, we got him to above average on that. Nice. Let's wait him on playing time a little bit. There we go. This guy's got a visit coming up. Promises left on this guy? Yeah, I can't really promise anybody playing time anymore. Used to be, I'm like, yeah, no red shirt? No problem. Got you. Now I'm like, I gotta think about it. I'm kind of stacked. Wait, where are you from? New Jersey? Probably. Yeah, I'm not gonna worry about that stuff. Importance on this. Well, there you want to know. How about this too? Very high. Again, good. Now, did he already say? High, above average. Ooh.
very high. All right, go with that. All right, 78 overall. Back is here. Not for me. Might depend on him. The solution. Well, okay, there it did a little bit. Oh, okay. Yeah, it says low bandwidth. All right. I guess I'm having a little bit of issue there. Probably should have found out. Go ahead and offer him a scholarship. Pretty much say you'll get good national exposure. Here. Okay. Important. Low. Yeah, you know, the more often you type lag, the better it's going to be. Because that's just how it works. So, by all means, keep typing leg. Exposure. Yeah. I don't know what constitutes that, but I've got to think we're getting that. Lag, 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 blue lag. Yes, I know. I see it. Oh, Raw just started. Dang.
Hard or anything.
What do we got left on this board that's important? Well, a lot of stuff, I guess. Yeah, I already set up these visit things, I can tell. Recruiting is so much easier when you're the national champion. Yeah, I could do without the leg. I don't know why it's doing it now. I'm glad it didn't do it so much during the game.
Guy doesn't seem to care much about stuff that's good for us. Too bad. I can make that happen for Joey. Oh, excuse me. To call time. Let's go with, we got an athlete here. Everything's lower than that here. So let's go. Let's split it between two guys here. Excuse me. Let's schedule a visit with him. One more guy, we'll give 30 minutes. Let's give it to, how far back are we here? Oh, not very far. I got a lot of tackles I'm talking to though. How far back are we on the DN? More. Let's do this. About him, and that's all the recruiting time we have. Okay, let's advance the week. See if anybody commits and who we have next. Florida's next, 16. Let's see if they move up or stay there or go down. We should jump in front of Georgia, I would think. Ranking wise, we got people committing all over the place. Are we going to get any commits? Let's find out.
Can't tell you how many times back in the day I fell asleep during this screen, like late at night. Okay, advance the week. Oh. 'Cause it takes a good chunk of time. Pretty sure it's 5 minutes. Really?
Okay, self, you don't need to talk like that here. Two here, deep line. What were their overalls? I want to see. So we're now number 5. Florida jumps up to 14. We got to go on the road and play Florida. That should be interesting. I just want to see these two that
committed here. Iowa State, so we'll remove him. Oh, one overall outside linebacker. That's 77 overall D tackle. So now we have six committed already. All 77 overall or above. No, 76 overall or above. Nice. Okay. I got another tackle that's a soft commit to UMass. Looking pretty good. Pretty good shape here. Okay. Well, I think that's pretty much where we're going to leave the stream. I got to make sure to save this since it's not on autosave.
Couldn't remember if this was on the hard drive or a cloud save. I got it as a cloud save.
Will I stream tomorrow? I'll definitely try to. By the time I'm paranoid, I'm going to save this again. Okay. We should be good. Season stats. Where's Meadows? Meadows is third. Nice. Rushing leaders. Yeah, Vincent's all the way down to 39. Hey, gotta run the ball more. Receiving leaders. Wesley's 35th. Our tight end's leading the way for us. Okay. Yeah, that's pretty much how I play, though. Look at our defense and tackles. Yeah. Reed's up there in interception leaders. I wouldn't expect this to be anywhere near anything on kicking leaders. Longest field goal, 50 yards. That's right, Patton does kicking and punting because he's better at both than the punter and or kicker. I can't remember which way it goes. Okay. Let's take a look at the top 25 really quick, maybe.
Okay, so Michigan's in. Oh, wow, look at that. You got Michigan and Michigan State 1 and 2, and clearly they play each other at some point. Wow. Oh, it's this week. 1 versus 2.
Oh, I almost want to see that game. Nice. Then you got Miami. Then you got Boise, UMass, Clemson, Notre Dame, South Carolina. Stanford, Ohio State. So you got three Big Ten teams in the top 10. Huh. All right. Well, I think that is going to be it for now. But thanks for joining me. It's fun to bring UMass back. We'll try to do it more often. Hopefully it won't be another 9-10 months before I do it again. That was too long. So, but I had just kind of gotten away from live streaming in general there. Kind of got in a rut, and now I'm kind of making up for it the other way. So, yeah. All right, guys. You guys have a great night. I don't know if I'll do another stream tonight or not. Just kind of depends on how things go around the place here. So, if not, I'll see you soon. But have a great night.